What defines people's lives are brushes with greatness. What is Michigan greatness? It's tradition. It is a bar that is raised so high that some people choose not to even attend the University of Michigan.
The team. Right. That human beings have an agency to be a part of a team, to be a part of something bigger than themselves.
I'm wondering how comfortable or uncomfortable you are with this perception that you're the savior of Michigan football.
I'm not comfortable with that at all, as I said. And what I ask is this is a team effort. That it's the faculty, it's the alumni, it's the students, it's the student athletes. Everybody that's for us is for us.
Former Michigan star quarterback Jim Harbaugh makes his debut as the head coach of the Wolverines.
I don't think there's been a more hyped or anticipated coaching debut than I can remember in our sport. And it's that way because Jim Harbaugh could have gone anywhere in America in any level and been the head coach. It was that way because he's a winner. He's proved himself time and time again. Jim Harbaugh chose to come home to Michigan, and the Michigan Jim Harbaugh era starts tonight in Salt Lake City.
First and 10 at the 19. Rudolph, can he make it pay? Yes, he can! Touchdown, Wolverines! Jackpot!
Again, Cook had to scramble, just lofts it up, and it is batted down. Jennings dribbling, and Devontae Thomas. Well, he has trouble with the snap, and the ball is free. It's picked up by Michigan State's Jalen Watts Jackson, and he scores on the last.
Spate throwing to the end zone. Got his man. Touchdown, Michigan. And it's J.U. Chesson. Full house behind him. He'll try to do it himself. Did he get there? No signal. No touchdown. Michigan has won it.
Pressure coming. Rudolph goes deep to the sideline, underthrown. It's caught inside the 5-yard line. This is the game. Michigan for the tie. 6 seconds to go, fourth and goal. Here comes a blitz. Rudolph to the end zone. In traffic. It is caught. Chesson, touchdown. His fourth of the game. Over the middle. With a leap goes Jake Butt. Sudfeld will throw it. Enzo. Batted around. It falls incomplete. Michigan survives.
Look there on 48. Spate back to pass. Throws a pass into the
Joey.
Ball. And grabbed by Joey Bosa, who runs down the left side. Bosa to the 15, to the 10, and the quarterback Spate takes him down to the 10.
We're done. A post and Rudolph put it on the money for 45. Third and goal, they give it to the fullback Harbaugh, who just pulls his way into the end zone. His fifth rushing touchdown of the season.
On first down, off the play fake,
option and pitches it backwards, and it's scooped up, and there goes Jabril Peppers. He's going to score going the other way and pad the Michigan lead.
Ride to the finish line.
Wilton Spate makes it official. The backflip from Peppers. And it's a Michigan win.
Isaac gets his first carry to that. He barrels in for a Michigan touchdown. What would you expect? Smith in the I formation. Hit and a safety by the Iowa defense. Beathard retreats, flips it in the flat screen. Touchdown. That whole drive was after Wadley. Right through. And the Hawkeyes have stunned the Wolverines. Michigan unbeaten no more. He believes this bunch has the belief necessary to pull this upset today. Harbaugh hasn't been back here since he was a player and guaranteed the Michigan victory, delivering on that in 86. Fake it to him. Spate gets the throw away. Intercepted. And another pick six for the Ohio State defense. Malik Hooker just walks in. Peppers at the goal line. Escapes the swarm. And Jabril Peppers has a line down the sideline. Has to spin free. Hill again. Pure power football. Muscles in for the maize and blue. Michigan reclaims the lead. Barrett looks the other direction, off the hands of Saviour, intercepted by Peppers. Look out! Peppers with the ball in his hand, electric, spun down at the 43. To his 35, and Johnston takes off on a fake and doesn't get there. Comes back, looks in the flat, and delivers it in a touchdown. Spade steps up, delivers, intercepted. Picked off by Jerome Baker. And Baker's got blockers. Tackle inside the 15. Third and 7. Barrett has a lot of time. Now delivers downfield. Incomplete. And here comes a flag. Spate across the middle. Touchdown. Darbo went down low. There was hesitation on the call. Keeper. Hit. Right at the marker. The spot will decide it. And this is going to be scrutinized. It's clear in Harbaugh's mind.
After review, the play stands as called on the field.
Saviour cuts it back. Ohio State wins. Michigan's misery in this building continues. Ohio State perseveres and prevails 30-27 in double overtime.
See, I'm bitterly disappointed in the officiating. Can't make that any more clear. It was not, my view of the first down was as it was that short.
Here's Francois on the run. Creason ends up, has the first down, has the sideline. One man left to beat. Spate looking that way. Finds Hill and he's in. Touchdown. Handoff. It's Evans. Gets a great block. Sideline. Evans. Gets there. Touchdown. And Gavin will run it up. Across the 20, up the middle of the field.
ultimately, this is why nobody likes you. Now, I don't want to hear about your scenarios. I don't want to see Zapruder film about a spot. He got to the 15. They made the ruling on the field. They're not overturning it. Don't let it come down to that. Rise above it. Look, ultimately, you got to go and you got to win these games. If I told you Michigan was going to go into this game and throw a pick six, you'd say, well, we're losing. If I told you you'd turn it over three times, not have a first down in the fourth quarter, you'd tell me, man, yeah, we lost that game. You lost the game. That's it. You want to complain and say somehow things are unfair? Whatever, man. Wasn't the refs throwing a pick six? It's why there's a phrase about Michigan. It's simple. They've never lost. They just simply run out of time. And from Lloyd blaming the crown on the field all the way to this, it's never changed. You handed Ohio State 14 points, and OSU missed two chip shot field goals. Win the game. Be better. But just like you couldn't do anything in the fourth quarter at Iowa, you couldn't do anything in the fourth quarter here. That's the real deal.
And in 25 games, what's his biggest win? Wisconsin?
I think at home?
Maybe? Is it a three-win Michigan State team on the road? Mike, I'm just sick of it. As a fan, as a person, Harbaugh needs to be better.
29-yard run. Spate is going to have plenty of time to set up here and go downfield. Tariq Black waiting. Touchdown for the Super Frosh. Fresh new talent on the field. Look at this.
Just the fourth night game in Michigan Stadium history, and there is a rare energy for this rivalry game in here tonight. Of course, this is his second start as a Wolverine as Ty Isaac takes it, loses the football. Ball is out. Spartans are pointing their direction. And they have it. Short in the end around and flip it. Look out. A convoy. London. London calling. Touchdown, Michigan State. McHugh, the tight end. Now he loses the ball. It comes out, and the Spartans recover it. O'Born looks over the middle, incomplete. Now it's intercepted. Over the receiver's head, and David Dowell's got it. And the third takeaway for the Spartans sets them up in Michigan territory.
He lost the football. It's free. The Irish pick it up. Ball game.
Wilson shows the speed in the clear midfield and they're going down. Shane Patterson knocked back inside the five. Recovery intercepted. Picked up by the red hand. Pick six Wolverines.
Patterson. Winding up. He's got a receiver. Peoples Jones down the sideline.
Couldn't hang with us. We did what we had to do. Sometimes your little brother starts acting up, and you just got to put him in place.
Patterson flushed. Looks to the end zone. Touchdown! Donovan Peoples-Jones. And then flips it right into the hands of Brendan Watson. Watson headed down the sidelines. Still going. Wolverines pick six.
Here's Haskins, under pressure this time, and he finds his man. Haskins, touchdown again! Chris Olave! Haskins spring out, sets up the deep, up with a man. Touchdown! Buccaneers, Giants! Patterson, in the corner, Patterson, Nico Collins! Oh, what a catch! Touchdown, Michigan! Moody kicking it away to McCall. And McCall bounces off of his foot. And the Wolverines have it. Michigan with a timeout left. First and goal at the 9. Patterson drops it off. Wide open. Evans touchdown. Michigan. And it's blocked. Ohio State got it. Blocked out of the air. Towards the end zone. Touchdown Buckeyes. Campbell down the sideline. Watch out! Campbell turns on the juice. Touchdown, Buckeyes!
And Piron gets into the secondary at 3rd and 20 and gets into the end zone. Jay Patterson tipped ball at the line and it's intercepted. Gardner Johnson to the house.
They'll try to get to the sideline. Clock goes to all zeros, and Florida, with a dominant performance in the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl, they win it 41-15.
The Wolverines lose 63-39. They are 1-14. Let me repeat that. 1-14 in their last 15 against the Buckeyes. Jim Harbaugh, 0-4 against Ohio State as Michigan head coach. Stephen A., I want to start with you on this. Should Harbaugh be on the hot seat?
No. He shouldn't be on the hot seat simply because I think when you look at the Michigan program, I think we've overrated them. I think it's time for Michigan to come on home with the rest of us and recognize that this elite program, your brand is exceptional. There's no doubt about that. But what you've actually accomplished, I mean, what has it been? Think about the last time the Michigan Wolverines have been in the national championship picture. What are we going back to, Max? The 70s, I think? Somewhere along those lines, maybe some point.
They think more of themselves, the fans do, than what they really are. Beat Ohio State at least one time, and to have your vaunted defense get crushed because of crossing routes, I mean, that's on the coach. That's coaching.
Harbaugh can't develop a quarterback, period. But they should be patient with Harbaugh, in fact. Almost no matter what happens this year, they should be patient.
In the big games, your coach is a fraud. That was a beatdown of biblical proportions. And for my money, that's one of the three worst losses in the history of Michigan football. Nobody brought Harbaugh here to pound on Minnesota. You didn't bring him here for sleepovers. You didn't bring him here for revenge tours. You didn't bring him here so they could re-landscape the midfield logo in East Lansing. You brought him here to win championships, both divisionally, conference, and national. He is 4 years deep. He has won nothing. Zero. Nothing. Did anyone watch film? Did anyone have an idea of what Ohio State would try to do? Your season's a failure. You got blitzed by the two best teams you played. And your coach is 4 years deep and almost $40 million. And in the biggest games, he can't do it. He just can't do it.
I've just been spitting the truth about him. He has underperformed in spite of a 10-3 record. If he wins that game last year, he plays for the Big Ten championship against Northwestern, and he goes to the playoff. And he didn't just lose. He got destroyed. That's the problem up there.
What bold prediction can you give us for this upcoming college football season?
Well, I do think Michigan's going to the playoff, so that may be relatively bold.
Hopkins to throw. Hopkins stepped up, sacked, lost. Michigan has a football. And the Wolverines survive. Quinny Pave knocked it loose and grabbed it.
Second and goal at the 7. And they'll run it. Wisconsin has it. Same story for the Wolverines. Slippery fingers.
Here's JT looking. First, JT. First down. Jonathan Taylor rolling. Touchdown. Wisconsin 72 yards.
Steps up in the pocket. Decides to run it. Look at the breakaway speed. Can he get there? Touchdown, Wisconsin. 25 yards. Jack.
There's a problem there. You have to lift up the hood and find out what is wrong.
There's no juice. There's no energy.
It looked like they had never watched Wisconsin football before. Right now, man, I'm sick about how Michigan football looks right now. And I came here on this show, man. This is my first weekend on Big Noon Kickoff. And I came here with high expectations for how my team was going to look in front of you guys. And I'll be honest with you, man, I'm embarrassed. I'm embarrassed about that.
Stanley under pressure. Stanley dropped again. Cameron McGraw, first man to him, 8th sack of the day for the Wolverines. Woodson has been terrific out of the backfield receiving. Stanley in trouble. Stanley retreating. Stanley throws. Caught. Goodson gets to midfield, dives forward, but won't have enough.
What a series.
Victory formation for the Wolverines. And how about that? Michigan went back to the drawing board after the embarrassing loss at Camp Randall. They executed well last week against Rutgers, shutting them out. Came into this game, a big game.
Clifford launching for the end zone. Fryer move goes up. Touchdown, Penn State. This feels urgent for Michigan. Clifford lofting for the end zone. And there's got a touchdown. And not even close. No, that's about what he did in the warm-up. Harbaugh doesn't go with Nordine, who's got a huge leg, but has been inconsistent.
I mean, I'm with you. Nordine, usually, he's the guy usually in warm-ups we watch, and we're like, my gosh, this guy can kill the ball.
He banged it from 55 with room to spare. Yeah. High man rush, Patterson, spooks, flushed, sacked! Crowd in the center of the line. Charbonnet breaks free and scores standing up. And back come the maize and blue. Sneak. Patterson pushing right near the goal line. Where will they spot it? The suspense is killing. Oh! Touchdown, Michigan. They muscle it in on fourth down. Patterson escapes. delivers incomplete in the end zone. Burrow couldn't come up with it. And Penn State makes a stand. No completed passes yet for Patterson, but Haskins has been the weapon, and he's in the secondary. Hurdling tacklers and knocked down at the Notre Dame 40. Haskins, first free, breaking tackles into Notre Dame territory, and they'll finally run him down near the 25. So Collins, touchdown! And Michigan begins to pour it on to the Irish.
Patterson, near side, Donovan Peoples-Jones making people miss. Brennan, touchdown, Wolverines! Standing at the 26.
And it's blocked! It's loose! Michigan State recovers, but the Wolverines block it. Kalik Hudson, the Viper.
Side of that block, and then boom. Gets it off the foot of the punter. The pride of McKeesport, Pennsylvania, Kalik Hudson. What a huge play for Jim Harbaugh's Michigan team, who now have a chance to really put this one away.
The Wolverines take over first and 10 at the Michigan State 22. Charbonnet in the backfield. Patterson to throw. Steps. Caught. Touchdown. Nico Collins. Lewerke sprinting out of the pocket. Intercepted. Laverne Hill, second interception of the day for Brian Lewerke.
Hill is right there, and Laverne Hill, third interception of the year. Michigan seems to be pouring it on now. This team is a completely different team.
It's back. Looks like another touchdown for Michigan. And the Wolverines have really put it all on the road.
Ohio State.
Second down and two at the 22. Patterson. And they'll reverse it. Near side. Sanders still. Hits the corner. Down the sideline. Dives! Touchdown, Wolverines! The extra point, Quinn Nordine, who's been a red-hot kicker for the Wolverines over the last few games. And he missed it. Steps up. Delivers deep down the field. He's got a receiver. A live early touchdown, Buckeye! Fields to throw it, pump fake, scrambles, sets, fires, touchdown, Garrett Wilson, wow, down, dives, dives, touchdown, Ohio State.
And he's looking deep, Jones taking a shot for Devontae Smith, it's caught, it's a touchdown for Bama. As Patterson throws another deep ball that's nowhere near his guy. Alabama. Gonna hand it off here, and Harris will score with 27 seconds to go. Another long throw. And that one's caught inside the five. McCarty set up the screen. He has it here. Dives, touchdown, Michigan State. If he does, his game is over. Well, they got him drawn off again. To the end zone again. Miles Marshall for the Indiana touchdown. Playing, so an end zone shot. Up top, and caught touchdown. Freifogel's got it, and both Indiana touchdowns have come on free plays. First down from the 47, he looks to throw again. Clean pocket again. That ball's thrown right to a defender. He's got one in all three games. He's still alive. He's got a couple of blocks to take him. Third down and 25. Rushing just three this time. So Milton has time to size things up downfield. Now gets Chase. Heaves it downfield, and it's picked off by Matthews.
Because you got a football team to be crazy for.
Another landmark win for Tom Allen and the Hoosiers. They beat Michigan for the first time since 1987.
And they do so convincingly, 38-21. To end a three-game losing skid. Ambrosio, it's sailing off to the left and no good. Motion by Ronnie Bell. Snap to McNamara. And leaping in is Hassan Haskins. Touchdown, Michigan. Now to keep the game alive on 4th and 9. Throwing for the end zone into double coverage and intercepted, and Michigan wins. Daxton Hill seals the deal, and Michigan's losing streak comes to an end. Cade McNamara and ultimately Daxton Hill finish off a 48-42 three overtime win.
What happens if we went out, huh? Who's going to remember all the games before, man? We
did
went
we
out.
Call these breaks, son, man?
We did our job. He said we're going to dominate the second half of the season.
Yes, sir!
Jim Harbaugh is not going to survive. I mean, you don't start cutting someone's salary after doing a lousy job the last couple of years and expect him to suddenly do something that he hasn't done. We had these conversations in the past, Greeny. I would get blowback from Michigan fans.
They haven't developed. Get a great quarterback. They got really bad quarterback play ever since he's gone.
So I'd ask this question, P, like, since
it wouldn't matter if they got rid of him today, because I think at the end of the year,
there's very few teams in the Big Ten that you could say Michigan's better than now and in the future.
The players who have pride in their own personal performance, and who want to fight like hell for Michigan. That's essentially saying what he's trying to find. Are there any guys on the roster that can encapsulate that for him?
They need to start taking a different approach, because being Michigan isn't enough anymore.
According to ESPN's Football Power Index, Michigan has a 2% chance to win its division.
Put him on the cart, and they're going to take Ronnie Bell back to the locker room.
See that there? That emotional embrace tells me not awesome.
So first and 15 for Dylan Morris, second-year starter, started every game last season. All four of them, he hands it off to Richard Newton, and he is flattened behind the line of scrimmage by Josh Ross, an outside linebacker. The huge hole for Corum. Goodbye. The one play after the fake punt gets them the first down. Corum goes 67 for a Wolverine score.
Beats Ohio State.
So Ohio State can be bad, but Michigan is very bad. So I'm going to go on and say this is absolutely false. It is still the Michigan team of old. We know this Michigan team. They beat a Washington team that lost to Montana.
They only completed one pass in the second half against Rutgers. One, can Michigan go out there and throw the football to move it?
Flea flicker. Is anybody open in the end zone? Touchdown, Wolverines! Cornelius Johnson, McNamara, put it on the money. 34 yards. McCarthy drops it in. McCarthy, touchdown, Michigan.
It's great to be a Michigan Wolverine. It's great to be a Michigan Wolverine. It's great to be a Michigan Wolverine. It's great.
They had that kind of vibe about them from, you know, when they first stepped in the locker room when we got here early this morning. The vibe was they weren't going to be denied.
We've seen great starts from Harbaugh teams before, although this is only the second time that they've gotten to 5-0. So what is the bottom line for the Michigan Wolverines? Everyone's going to start to think about, like, well, is this the year for Michigan? Is this the year that they can beat Ohio State? Stop. Stop. I know that everyone is going to want to know if this is the team that can compete with and beat Ohio State. Wait for that week. Just look at it a game at a time.
Yeah, okay, Michigan. Undefeated, but
who they beat?
Yeah, who have
they beat
and they lacks the explosion offensively, I'm putting them out.
Ooh, pretender.
Haskins with lots of room. Haskins up and over. Still going inside the 30 and tripped up from behind by Nick Henrich. One of the runs of the season in college football by Hassan Haskins. And it's a design run for Martinez and a first down. And the ball is out. And apparently it had not been stopped. Brad Hawkins has it. And he returns it inside the 20-yard line.
Well, Hawkins ripped it out and recovered it.
Martinez throwing it deep and incomplete. Broken up by Dax Hill on action two.
I think Michigan teams in the past, no disrespect, but I think since I've been at Michigan, I think we lose this game sometimes. And I think it's a testament to the guys in that locker room, the coaches who have made a commitment to make this year different.
That's the one we fight. We got heart like that.
Who's got it better than us?
Nobody!
We've sensed it all year long. We've done three Michigan games now. There's just a totally different vibe around that building.
Michigan won the toss. The Fur Spartans will receive the football. Jake Moody will kick it away. Michigan, Michigan State, and here we go from East Lansing. And five at the seven. McNamara standing strong in the pocket, and it's caught. Anthony with a burst. Anthony down the sideline. Third down and three. Walker. Kenneth Walker. Walker down. 58 yards. Touchdown. Spartan. McNamara looking. Intercepted. Bradley. Ball game. The Spartans said they were tough. The Spartans said they would flinch. And they did. Michigan State.
Yeah, this didn't go the way we wanted it to. And we're going to have to learn from it and strengthen our resolve moving forward.
I think we're still in contention. We still got all our goals in front of us.
You know, we got to be able to bounce back, and, you know, we can't let this game define our season.
We watched Jim Harbaugh lose another big game, had a big lead, ended up losing to Michigan State. You know what? He's got a game coming up against Ohio State. We know that he's allergic to beating Ohio State. That doesn't seem to be able to happen.
We may have just seen the Jim Harbaugh era die in East Lansing.
A lot of controversy in the rankings earlier this week. Michigan was ranked ahead of Michigan State despite losing to them just about, a few days before.
Well, I mean, here's the thing with Michigan. Penn State's been a thorn in their side when they've gone there. When they've gone to Happy Valley, it's been over quick, fast, and in a hurry. So Penn State's a good team.
So if you go up to Happy Valley and you pull off a victory, then that's a well-deserved W.
For 106,000, four-man rush on first and 10. McNamara throws a touchdown. Roman Wilson on a beautifully thrown ball by Cade McNamara. And Michigan takes the lead. Expect Haskins here. They fake it to him and throw a touchdown. Second for Roman Wilson. Maybe he should wear a cast every week. Third down and 11. McNamara taken down. The ball is out. Emma Cady sacked him. And it is Penn State ball. Here comes a Penn State blitz. Lots of running room down the sideline. Eric Gold, the tight end. Will they catch him? No! Touchdown, Michigan! And the lead with 3.5 to go.
The This one means a lot. It means a lot for the guys who've been here. We were so close 2 years ago. We didn't pull it through, but we pulled this one through. When I came to Michigan, especially with the class that we came in with, we wanted to be the change. We wanted to make a difference. I mean, I've said it multiple times before. This team is different, and couldn't love those guys anymore.
How we deal with adversity?
It's my quarterback.
How about those Wolverines? That's not good, I don't know what it is.
You were born for this. You guys were born for days like this. And the way you guys fight this championship up, this championship fighting up.
Ohio State has dominated this matchup in, frankly, for the last two decades. Is there a reason to believe this weekend will be different?
No, no, no. Greeny, you can ask me this question until I'm 150, and the answer is still no. I don't think this Michigan team, although they are better than they have been, significantly better, can beat Ohio State. This is a really good, if not great, Ohio State team. And I think there's something in Jim Harbaugh's brain. I don't know what it is. I don't really want to know. He is incapable, Brady, of beating his biggest rival.
We're going to do it or die tonight.
And here's a reverse. Hey, good point. Headings. Touchdown, Michigan.
Ohio
group of kids and a coaching staff in my entire life than I am of this 2021 version of the Michigan Wolverines.
This is why I come back. This, all this is why I come back.
You credited Aiden Hutchinson, but they came in for a reason this season to make difference.
We did it, though.
Teams in the country now, everyone placing them. But I'll say this, what impresses me the most is there's been a lot of talk and discussion about Jim Harbaugh and Michigan, where they're at, and all that. They believe what no one else did. They're the only team in the college football playoff era that was unranked on the AP poll coming into the season to make it into the college football playoff. We haven't seen that before. Jim Harbaugh spoke about it at the Big Ten media days, and they've literally made it a reality for themselves. Credit the coaching staff, credit the players for believing in themselves that they could accomplish something no one else thought.
What made them so special?
Well, first of all, it's the best group of guys, coaches, players, mighty men and women of Michigan football.
Everybody talks and has an opinion about Jim Harbaugh. You came home. You're around this program as a kid. You played here, won a Big Ten championship. You came back to Michigan to put Michigan back in its rightful spot in the top tier of college football. Coach, you've achieved that tonight. How does it feel?
It feels like a great team effort, complete team effort. And I want to thank all the great Michigan faithful. Go Blue!
Well, other than that, you wanted to leave a legacy at Michigan. Seems like you've been able to do that. How does it feel?
Punch for Heisman! Punch for Heisman! Punch for Heisman!
Hey, man. I'm just so... Hey! To win the Big Ten Championship here, with the best teammates ever and the best coach in the world, man. I'm so proud of everybody. I'm speechless. There's no words that I can describe for this, man.
Group of seniors that stayed, that wanted to put you guys back on top, and now find yourself together back on top of the mountain.
Yeah. Last year we went 2-4. Everybody had to invest in this culture and this team. And as you see today, we did. Every single player invested in our culture and what we did. And I'm so proud of everybody. This wouldn't be possible without all 130, 140 of the players on this football team.
Jim Harbaugh has been the story of the year because it was a year ago when some of his own people were starting to wonder if he was the right coach, Reese. He took a contract cut. He didn't say a word, and I really admired that by Jim Harbaugh. A lot of people would whine and complain. He just put his head down and did what he is supposed to do. He's done the best coaching job of anybody in the country. I would vote for him as National Coach of the Year.
The main mission was to come back, was to beat Ohio State and win a Big Ten championship. And
Hey, Kenny, I'm glad you're in between them.
That's good.
And you know,
please stay there.
Better than his offensive lineman.
Oh.
Just okay. Throw him under the bus.
And you know, we did those things, so now we're in the playoffs, so we got a chance.
McIntosh is going to throw it. Lobs to the end zone. Caught. Touchdown, Mitchell. Bennett backpedals, scrambles, heaves downfield. It's caught. Jermaine Burton scores.
Bennett looking to throw for it under pressure. Hammered, but he lobs it out to Cook, who collects it and sprints for a touchdown.
McCarthy launches, and a diving catch. McCarthy has a man wide open, and it's caught by Andrell Anthony, freshman to freshman, and finally, Wolverines find the end zone tonight.
I mean, nothing's going to take away our accomplishments this year and what we achieved for what we were expecting. So, I'll forever love this team. We did some amazing things, some historic stuff. Yeah, this is we climbed mountains this season that no one thought we could. We did some things that you know, nobody expected this Michigan team to do. And I think we set the standard, the future of Michigan football. And we really helped this program tremendously for the future. Those young guys, they got this scar tissue now, being in the playoffs, losing, you know, having to feel this. I know they're going to bounce back next year and give them hell.
Well, obviously, it's very disappointing right now. I mean, we gave, you know, everything we got, and we got beat tonight. But I think, once we give it a little time, we'll be able to appreciate a lot of the great things we were able to accomplish this season. But, you know, after a loss, you're obviously going to take it hard, and, you know, we're a competitive group, but that's not going to take away from, you know, the great things that we had this season as well.
Yeah, to piggyback what Kay said, you know, we did accomplish great things this year, and although it is a disappointing way to end it, we did do great things this year, and we can't forget about that. Today we got outplayed, and it wasn't the best game for us. But as far as the season, as far as a whole, we had so many great moments with our group, such a great culture that we built here. And like Coach Harbaugh says, it's just the beginning of what we've built, what we are building, and moving on to next year.
As we just talked about in there, the team's not going to be the same next year, but it's a start. It's one of the, I know it when. Michigan history, I don't believe it's one of the best teams ever. I know it is right in there. So it's a beginning. Onward.
You say right in there, I know what those young men in that locker room mean to you. They allowed you to silence a lot of people who didn't believe. What does that mean to you?
Yeah, they're fighters. The way they train, the way they play, you know, means everything. Means everything. Those are my friends.
I appreciate your time.
All right.
Thank you so much. Great season, Coach.
Hutchinson, Hassan Haskins, some of the Michigan seniors walking off. Hutchinson looked up in the stands and blew kisses in appreciation for his time here. Last time he'll wear that Michigan uniform as he exits. And it was interesting watching some of the true freshmen, Andrell Anthony, Donovan Edwards, and J.J. McCarthy, who ultimately played pivotal roles down the stretch in this game. That was, yes, a blowout. They stayed and watched Georgia players take the stage to get on stage and accept the Orange Bowl trophy and move on to the championship. So you heard it there from Michigan's head coach, Jim Harbaugh. He believes that there's more buzz in this program, that this is the beginning of something new. That freshman class hoping to put that new stamp on it.
One, two. You know what to do.
Hail to the victor crowning. Hail to the conquering heroes. Hail, hail to Michigan, the leaders and best. Hail to the victors crowning. Hail to the conquering heroes.